Now I want to go ahead and do a more complex bond example. In particular, I want to go ahead and think about a bond that pays coupons. So in our earlier example, I had a zero coupon bond. But now let's think about a bond that has a $1,000 face value. And when a bond is first issued, its coupons are fixed at that time. And the coupon yield expresses the size of the coupons compared to the face value of the bond. So if a bond has a coupon yield of 5%, then the yearly coupons are going to be 5% times the face value of the bond. And then we can go ahead and think about what interest rates are out there in the market. And I'm going to suppose that interest rates have risen since the time this bond was issued. Now we want to go ahead and think about an overall timetable of payments. So here's going to be how far in the future a given payment arrives. And then we're going to go ahead and think about what the present value, what the payment on that date is. And then we're going to think about what the present value of that payment is. So something could arrive 0 months in the future or 0 years in the future. And it turns out that coupons are usually paid twice per year. So I'm going to go ahead and have things go forward half a year at a time here. So we're going to go ahead and copy this down here. So we're going to let this bond go out 10 years into the future. And we're not going to get any immediate payment on our bond. And then at each half yearly interval, we're going to go ahead and get half of our coupons. And I'm going to go ahead and put a little dollar sign here in front of the 3 so that when I copy this down, it's going to go ahead and stay the same. And then on our very last day here, on our very last period, we get not just a coupon payment, but we also get paid the face value of the bond. So I'm going to go back up here and add that in. So we get $25 every 6 months until the maturity of the bond, when we get both our last coupon and we get repaid our face value. So what's the present value of the payment on each date? Well, remember that in general, the present value of some payment in the future is going to be the payment at that point in the future over 1 plus the interest rate. Now here, the relevant interest rate is the market interest rate. And then we raise that to the number of years in the future that the payment arrives. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this down all the way here. And I think I must have made a mistake in my formula somehow. Yeah, so what I did here was I forgot to keep this from changing. So I need to go ahead and do that. Okay, so this should look better now. Okay, that does look better. So we see that the first $25 payment that arrives 6 months, half a year in the future, is worth almost $25 to us. And each successive $25 payment is worth a little bit less to us because it's farther and farther in the future. And we know that things that happen farther in the future are worth less to us. And notice that although we get paid $1,000 of principal back in 10 years' time, if we have a market interest rate, an opportunity cost of waiting of 8%, well, something that's 10 years in the future, if it costs us 8% per year to wait, isn't worth that much to us. You can see that it's worth less than 50 cents on the dollar. Now, the overall present value of the bond is the sum of all the payments that we could receive from owning the bond. So the overall present value of the bond is is the total present value of all the payments. And so the present value of this bond is $805, less than the $1,000 face value. And that's because the market interest rate is higher than the coupon yield. Effectively, this thing is paying a 5% rate of return on its face value, but other investments are paying 8%, so this thing looks relatively less attractive. If the market interest rate were to decline below the coupon yield, then this thing sells for more than its $1,000 face value, because it's offering a higher rate of return than the market interest rate as a whole, so this $1,085 present value or market value will deliver the 4% rate of return. So that is essentially how we would go about valuing a bond that actually does pay some coupons here. Last thing I want to talk about here is what's called the current yield of a bond. The current yield of a bond is the yearly coupons it pays over its current market price. And we can see that this bond, then, at a price, if the price is $1,085, it has a current yield of 4.6%. And again, the current yield is going to change when the market interest rate yields, when the market interest rate changes, because when the market interest rate changes, the present value, the fair market price, the fundamental value, is going to go ahead and change. So. And notice that when the market interest rate rises, the present value of the bond falls, and the current yield therefore rises as well. So that's how we would do a more complex case of bond valuation.